أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم My third year students Today we will discuss hypothesis and what is a hypothesis what are the objectives of this lecture By the end of this session that is this lecture we should be able to know what is a hypothesis what are the types of hypothesis stating hypothesis, the null and alternate hypothesis, the alpha and the beta errors, steps of testing hypothesis, the p-value and power of the study. What is hypothesis? Hypothesis ko Urdu mein mafruza bhi kehte hain, qiyas bhi kehte hain, nazariya bhi kehte hain. And the bookish definition of hypothesis is that a supposition or conjecture put forth to account for known facts which serves as a starting point for further investigations by which it may be proved or disproved. And this is actually inferential statistics. What are the uses of hypothesis? It is used in experimental trials to assess the efficiency of a vaccine or pharmaceutical preparations. And to investigate the usefulness of two regimes. I found some interesting synonyms for this word, that is hypothesis. These are the synonyms for hypothesis found on net. Assignment, assumption, that is hypothesis means an assignment, an assumption, attribution, axiom, basis, belief, conjecture, derivation, explanation, foundation, ground, guess, inference, interpretation, layout, philosophy, plan, postulate, speculation, suggestion, supposition, theorem, thesis, proposal, proposition. Hypothesis is a statement showing expected relation between two variables. And a hypothesis is needed in the following study designs. These are four study designs in which we apply hypothesis. All interventional studies like randomized control trials and non-randomized control trials, cohort studies, case control studies and comparative cross-sectional studies. Actually, all these four are the comparative studies. And randomized control study In randomized control study, we compare treatment, say different types of treatments or different types of surgical procedures. And similarly, in non-randomized control trials and cohort studies, we compare exposed and non-exposed groups. While in case control studies, we compare the cases and controls. And cross-sectional studies. We compare the comparative cross sections. We compare two studies. There are two types of hypothesis. One is known as the null, denoted by H sub 0, and another one is known as alternate and is denoted by H sub A. Now, the null hypothesis or H sub A sub 0, and this is stated as there is no association or there is no difference between variable A and variable B. While the alternate hypothesis say the null is false and there is an association. How do we represent mathematically the hypothesis? Null hypothesis is represented just like this one, that is mu is actually a parameter, say A. Or a variable and k is another variable. So, k is the claim and this mean that is maybe sometimes this is x bar or y bar and this is known as the parameter. Now, the null hypothesis say that this parameter is equal to or less than the claim. The alternate hypothesis say no, this parameter is more than the k. That is the claim. If null hypothesis say, okay, then this parameter is equal to or more than the claim or k, the null will say that no, null is actually the opposite of the alternate is actually the opposite of null. Now the if the null say mu is equal to or greater than k, then alternate hypothesis will say this mu is lesser than k. If null hypothesis say mu is equal to k, alternate hypothesis will say no, it is not equal to k. Now this is actually normal distribution curve. These three are the normal distribution curves. I don't think you people will understand this normal curve just now, because we will discuss this normal curve in statistics, by statistics, which we will be doing inshallah in your fourth year. Anyway, there is certain area in this normal curve. Say for example, from this area to this area, that is the say this area from here to here, this is the area which is between two standard errors or two standard deviations, and this is actually the area where we that is this area where we accept the null hypothesis, and the area outside this these two standard deviations or two standard errors, that is this one area and on this left side this area, these are known as the rejection areas. So if our test statistics falls in these two standard errors, then we cannot reject the null hypothesis, and we are supposed or we are compelled to accept the null hypothesis. While if our test statistics falls outside this two standard error area, then that is in these areas on either side, then we can say that we reject the null and the alternate is accepted or the alternate is correct. Almost the same graph, that is this is actually the area of non-rejection, this area written over here, non-rejection area, and the area beyond this two standard, this 1.6 means not exactly the I told you that outside this two standard deviation or two standard errors, this is actually 1.6 standard errors. This is actually the exact figure. Roughly we use the two standard errors on both sides, on minus side and plus side. So this is the area of non-rejection, means to say that if our test statistics falls in this area, we may not be able to reject the null hypothesis, and if it is otherwise, if the test statistics falls beyond this line on this side or on this side, then these are the rejection areas and we can reject the null hypothesis. The same graph. Now we will explain this hypothesis with an example. For example, there is a trial for treatment of a disease with two preparations, and a study is conducted to determine if it is successful or not. Statistically, there are four possibilities. For example, we want to compare two drugs, say for the treatment of typhoid fever. One is the older preparation, which is the quinolone, that is the ciprofloxacin and ofloxacin, And the next other treatment is, say, this is a treatment A. And treatment B is we compare this the quinolone group with the third generation cephalosporins, which are the ceftriaxone and क्या नाम है दूसरा क्लेफ्रान और रोसिफेन वगैरह. नाउ दिस इज से बी बी ग्रुप एंड वी वांट टू सी द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द दिस टू ग्रुप्स द ट्रीटमेंट ए एंड ट्रीटमेंट बी. नाउ स्टेटिस्टिकली देयर आर फोर पॉसिबिलिटीज. द ट्रीटमेंट डज हैव अ डिफरेंट इफेक्ट दैट इज वन इज बेटर देन द अदर. मे बी दिस वी से वी क्लेम दैट दिस third generation cephalosporins are better than the quinolones. Second option is possibility is the treatment has similar effects. Third one is the treatment may actually have similar effect, but it is concluded that the treatment is better. So we wrongly conclude that the treatment is better, and this is an error. ये एक गलती है और इसको दिस इज नोन एज टाइप वन एरर आर अल्फा एरर. एंड द फोर्थ पॉसिबिलिटी इज द ट्रीटमेंट इज हैविंग सिमिलर इफेक्ट बट इट इज रॉन्गली कंक्लूडेड दैट इट हैज डिफरेंट इफेक्ट. सो दीज आर द फोर पॉसिबिलिटीज व्हाइल वी आर टेस्टिंग दिस हाइपोथेसिस. Now, an example. If we want to know about the complications rate of two surgical procedures for cholecystectomy, practical example. One procedure for cholecystectomy is open cholecystectomy, which is the older version, and the latest procedure for this surgery is the laparoscopic cholecystectomy, shortly known as LAP-COLI. Now the null hypothesis will claim that there is no difference between the two surgical procedures with respect to post-op complications. So the null hypothesis say there is no difference between this these two procedures, that in that is the open cholecystectomy and laparoscopic one, LAP-COLI. While the alternate say that the difference is there, and this is basically the generally this null hypothesis is the sorry this alternate hypothesis is the research question framed by the researcher, and it may either be there are few possibilities there is difference in complications between open and LAP-COLI. There is difference means that either this one is better, the open one is better, or LAP-COLI is better. So this is this means that this procedure may be good or bad. So this is known as a two-tail hypothesis. कि कोई भी हो सकता है, गुड भी हो सकता है, बैड भी हो सकता है, इसके कॉम्प्लिकेशंस कम भी हो सकती है, ज़्यादा भी हो सकते हैं. दिस इज नोन एज द टू-टेल हाइपोथिसिस. वाइल if we say that open cholecystectomy has less complications than the LAP-COLI, then this is the one-tail hypothesis. And if we reverse this sentence, LAP-COLI has less complications than the open, again this is a one-tail hypothesis. Usually a null is usually against the claim of the researcher. Null hypothesis is usually the, while the alternate hypothesis is actually the research question. So null is usually against the claim of the researcher, and every researcher would like to reject this null hypothesis. If we are conducting a study like the I have pointed out earlier, the four types of studies, these studies, the interventional studies, cohort, case control, and comparative cross-sectional studies. If we are conducting these studies, we will have to apply a hypothesis, and would like to reject the null hypothesis. If we want to reject the null hypothesis, there are two possibilities. Number one, we reject the null hypothesis and we fail to reject the null hypothesis. In case of A, we reject the null hypothesis. In situation A, again there are two possibilities. We reject the null hypothesis and we are right. We reject the null hypothesis and we are wrong. We wrongly reject the null hypothesis. In situation B, that is, we fail to reject the null hypothesis. We fail to reject the null hypothesis and the true situation was that it should have not been rejected. So, our decision is right. We are right in doing so. The second possibility is we fail to reject the null hypothesis while it should have been rejected. So, we were wrong in this case. Hence, while dealing with null hypothesis, we can make both correct as well as incorrect decisions based upon the possible evidence available to us compared to the true situation in the universe. This is a 2x2 table where we compare the true situation and the decision based upon evidence. Now, our decision in this case, in this table, is based upon the a test, a procedure, or an examination. And we decide on the basis of evidence over here that difference exists between A and B, say treatment A and B, say the two procedures, the Lipkoli and the open cholecystectomy. So, we decide on the basis of evidence that difference exists over here, and or we decide, on the other hand, we decide that difference does not exist. While the true situation is difference is there. Now, the true situation says difference is there, and we also, on the basis of evidence, found that difference is there, so we are correct. This is a correct decision. If the true situation said difference is not there and we found that difference is there, now we are incorrect. There is an error, and this error is known as type 1 error. On the other hand, when we decide on the basis of evidence that difference exists, does not exist, difference does not exist, while the true situation is difference exists. So, in this case, we are incorrect, and this is known as type 2 error. If we found over here, we conclude over here that difference is there and the true situation difference is not there, and the true situation also says that difference is not there. In this case, again, we are correct. Now, another example, for example, this is a court case of a person, of a victim, and the court decides on the available evidence that the person is guilty, while the true situation over here says the person is guilty. Now, if the court decides the person is guilty and the true situation also is that the person is guilty, this is a correct decision. Now, if the court decides that the person is guilty, but the true situation is the person is not guilty, this is alpha R type 1 error. And if the court decides on the basis of evidence that the person is not guilty and the true situation is also over here, coming to this column, true situation is that the person is not guilty. Now, this is correct decision, but if the court decides that the person is not guilty and two situation is the person is guilty. This is beta R type 2 error. Now the null hypothesis in this case, in this court case, say that the person is innocent, while the alternate hypothesis say the person is guilty. जी यहाँ पे थोड़ा सा हम सिविलिटी को कर लें, एक्सप्लेन कर लें कि विच टाइप ऑफ एरर इज मोर सिवियर. फॉर एग्जांपल दिस इज अ केस ऑफ मर्डर, द विक्टिम इज अंडर ट्रायल, द कोर्ट डिसाइड्स ऑन एविडेंस बेस दैट इज द पर्सन इज गिल्टी एंड द ट्रू सिचुएशन इज दैट द पर्सन इज गिल्टी एंड दिस पर्सन इज गिवन कैपिटल पनिशमेंट, ही इज हैंग्ड. Now, the other possibility is court decides the person is guilty while the true situation is the person is innocent. In this case, the court decides that this person is not guilty, but the true situation is the person is guilty and the court quits this person. This is type 2 error or beta error. And over here the court say decide the person is not guilty and the person is not guilty, the court quits this person. This is correct decision. Now which error, that is alpha or this one, alpha or beta error is more severe or more serious? Over here in this case, in this beta error, and a guilty person is released, he is and then the court quits this person, this guilty person. While in this case, in alpha error, the court give capital punishment to an innocent person. So in this case, in this scenario, this alpha error is more serious, it is more severe. Now, to prove or disprove the null hypothesis, the p-value of equal to or less than 0.05, we reject the null hypothesis, the cutoff line. At this point, we will inshallah explain this, what do we mean by 0.05? 0.05 actually means 1 in 20 chances are 5% chances of error. So the p-value of equal to or less than 0.05, this is the cutoff line for acceptance or rejecting the null hypothesis. So if the p-value is equal to or less than 0.05, we reject the null hypothesis. Type 1 error is, as I explained earlier, we may mistakenly reject the null hypothesis when indeed it was true. And type 2 or beta error, we may also mistakenly accept the null when in fact it is false. Acha, yahan pe, in case of hypothesis, we normally use the terms as rejection or non-rejection. We do not use this acceptance word, although some books say that this is correct, but mostly we either say that we reject the null hypothesis or we fail to reject the null hypothesis. How much is the chance of error in decision? 0.05, that is p-value 0.05, 0.01, or say 5. This 0.05 actually means 5% or 1% chance, or which is the p-value. Now, type 1 error occurs when we reject this repetition actually. Type 1 or alpha error occurs when we reject a true null hypothesis, and type 2 or beta error occurs when we do not reject a false null hypothesis. There are four steps in hypothesis testing. Step 1, first step is state the hypothesis, that is what is your hypothesis, that the what is the null hypothesis and what is the alternate, the two types of hypothesis. And stating the hypothesis actually involves stating two opposing hypotheses, that is the null hypothesis and the alternate hypothesis are actually two opposing hypotheses. as I told you earlier in the mathematical presentation of hypotheses, that if null say this one, if null say this is greater than lesser than or equal to alternate say no, it is more than. If null say more than or equal to null say no, it is lesser than. Null say equal, alternate say no, it is not equal. So these are actually two opposing hypotheses. An example: suppose we are interested in the effect of a prenatal exposure of alcohol on the birth weight of rats. Also suppose that we know that the mean birth weight of the population of untreated lab rats is 18 grams. Null hypothesis states that the treatment has no effect, and for our example we formally state the null hypothesis that a prenatal exposure to alcohol has no effect on the birth weight of the population of lab rats, and the birth weight will be equal to 18 grams. While the alternate hypothesis says, this hypothesis states that the treatment does have an effect, and for our example we formally state this hypothesis, that is the alternate hypothesis, that the prenatal exposure to alcohol has an effect on the birth weight of the population of lab rats, and the birth weight will be different than 18 grams. Step number 2, set the criteria for decision. Now we will set a criteria for decision that whether we accept this error, type 1 error, is 0.05 or less than 0.05, say 0.03, 0.02, 0.01, 0.005, and so on. The researcher will be collecting data from a sample taken from the population to evaluate the credibility of this null hypothesis. And the criteria must be set to decide whether the kind of data we get is different from what we would expect under the null hypothesis. Specifically, we must set a criteria about whether the sample mean is different from the hypothesized population mean. And the criteria will let us conclude whether to reject the null hypothesis or accept the null hypothesis. Again, we do not use the word accept, we use the word that we were not able to reject the null hypothesis, and the treatment of the prenatal exposure to alcohol has an effect on the birth weight of the rats. Third step is collect sample data. Now we collect data, we do this by obtaining a random sample from the population, and in our example a random sample of rats receives daily dose of alcohol during pregnancy. At birth we measure the weight of samples of newborn rats, we calculate the mean birth weight. Step number 4, we compare the sample mean with the hypothesis about the population mean. If the data is consistent with the hypothesis, we conclude that the hypothesis is reasonable and we cannot reject the null hypothesis. If there is a big discrepancy between the data and the hypothesis, we conclude that the hypothesis was wrong, and so we reject the null hypothesis, this one. Our example, we compare the observed mean birth weight with the hypothesized value of 18 grams. Say the mean weight of the rat pups was 18 grams. If a sample of rat pups which were exposed to prenatal alcohol has a birth weight very near to 18 grams, we conclude that the treatment does not have any effect, and formally we do not reject, we are not able to reject the null hypothesis. If our sample of rat pups has a birth weight very different from 18 grams, we conclude that the treatment does have an effect, and formally we reject the null hypothesis. Acha yahan pe, over here we say that uh, यहाँ पे द सैम्पल विच आर एक्सपोज टू प्रिनेटल अल्कोहल वॉज वेरी नियर, यहाँ पे हम कह रहे हैं कि वेरी नियर टू 18 ग्राम्स, और यहाँ पे कह रहे हैं कि वेरी डिफरेंट फ्रॉम, व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय वेरी नियर, और क्या मतलब कि अगर 17 है तो वो ठीक है, अगर 16 है तो वो ज़्यादा है, या 16 है तो वो ठीक है और 14 है तो वो कम है। दिस इज़ एक्चुअली बाय स्टेटिस्टिक्स, और यहाँ पे इसको एक्सप्लेन करना थोड़ा सा मुश्किल होगा, इंशाल्लाह हम बाय स्टेटिस्टिक्स में डिटेल में इंशाल्लाह एक्सप्लेन करेंगे। नेक्स्ट इज दी कट ऑफ पी वैल्यू, एज आई एक्सप्लेन दैट पी वैल्यू ऑफ 0.05 मीन्स दैट देयर इज 1 in 20 चांस दैट द रिजल्ट्स आर बाई चांस एलॉन, दैट इज टाइप वन एरर, आर टाइप वन एरर आर एल्फा एरर, आर दैट देयर इज लेस देन अ 5% रिस्क दैट आवर सैम्पल इज नॉट अ ट्रू रिप्रेजेंटेटिव ऑफ द पॉपुलेशन इफ नल इज ट्रू, एंड पी वैल्यू ऑफ लेस देन 0.05 मीन्स 95% चांस दैट आवर सैम्पल इज रिप्रेजेंटेटिव ऑफ द पॉपुलेशन। पी इज एक्चुअली प्रॉबिबिलिटी ऑफ सम बुक से दैट पी इज कमिटिंग टाइप वन एरर एनी रिसर्च स्टडी, टाइप वन एरर इज द प्रॉबिबिलिटी ऑफ रिजेक्टिंग नल व्हेन इट इज एक्चुअली ट्रू, एंड दी प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ फॉल्सली रिजेक्टिंग द नल हाइपोथेसिस, द प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ गेटिंग अ रिजल्ट बाई चांस। अच्छा, पी वैल्यू, दिस इज अ कट ऑफ लाइन, इफ पी वैल्यू इज लेस देन इक्वल टू आर लेस देन 0.05, दिस मीन्स दैट देयर इज अ स्टेटिस्टिकली सिग्निफिकेंट डिफरेंस एंड नल हाइपोथिस इज रिजेक्टेड। इफ पी वैल्यू इज मोर देन 0.05, सो देयर इज नो स्टेटिस्टिकली सिग्निफिकेंट डिफरेंस एंड वी कैन नॉट रिजेक्ट द नल हाइपोथिस। सो द स्मॉलर द पी वैल्यू द मोर स्ट्रांगली द टेस्ट रिजेक्ट्स द नल हाइपोथिस, दैट इज द हाइपोथिस बीइंग टेस्टेड। द स्मॉलर द पी वैल्यू द मोर स्टेटिस्टिकल एविडेंस एग्जिस्ट टू सपोर्ट द अल्टरनेटिव हाइपोथिस नॉट द नल हाइपोथिस। इफ पी वैल्यू इज लेस देन 1%, दिस मीन्स पी इज इक्वल 2.01, यस देयर इज, इफ पी इज 0.01 इक्वल टू आर लेस देन 0.01, देयर इज ओवरवेलमिंग और अ वेरी स्ट्रांग एविडेंस दैट सपोर्ट्स द अल्टरनेटिव हाइपोथेसिस। वी रिजेक्ट द नल हाइपोथेसिस एंड सपोर्ट द अल्टरनेटिव हाइपोथेसिस विच इज आवर रिसर्च क्वेश्चन। इफ पी वैल्यू इज बिटवीन 1 and 5, दिस मीन्स दैट द पी वैल्यू लाइज बिटवीन 0.05 to 0.01, देयर इज स्ट्रांग एविडेंस दैट सपोर्ट्स द अल्टरनेटिव हाइपोथेसिस। इफ पी वैल्यू इज बिटवीन 5 to 10%, दैट इज 0.05 to 0.1, देयर इज अ वीक एविडेंस दैट सपोर्ट्स द अल्टरनेटिव हाइपोथेसिस, एंड इफ पी वैल्यू एक्सीड्स 0.1 or 10%, देयर इज नो एविडेंस दैट सपोर्ट्स द अल्टरनेटिव हाइपोथेसिस, एंड इन दिस केस वी कैन नॉट रिजेक्ट द नल हाइपोथेसिस, रादर आई विल से वी एक्सेप्ट द नल हाइपोथेसिस। व्हाट इज पावर ऑफ द स्टडी? Power of the study is actually the ability of a study to detect a difference if there really is a difference. So that we are the chances of committing errors of type 1 and type 2 or alpha and beta errors is very less. This is actually the power of a study, and this depends upon 4 factors: number of the study subjects in each treatment group, the alpha error, population variance, and the suspected magnitude of difference between the two treatments. There are 2 assignments for you people. A formula milk manufacturer claims that the mean weight of the contents of its 800 grams box is more than 800 grams. What you are supposed to do? Write the claim as mathematical sentence, state the null and the alternative hypothesis, and identify which represents the claim. Assignment number two. Assignment number two is, Nowshera Medical College claims that failing proportion of its students during the last 3 years is less than 5%. Right, the claim is, the questions are, there are three questions for this assignment. Write the claim as a mathematical sentence. State the null and the alternative hypothesis, and identify which represents the claim. This was all about the hypothesis. Thank you very much.